Hello everyone, how are you all? I hope you all are doing good. So welcome to our YouTube channel, and this is our very first video. So this channel I am going to launch to share my experiences and my journey from India to Germany as a student. So let's get started with my introduction. And I hope you all are also interested in giving your introduction in the comment section below. So yes, I am Manit Kera and I am from the Hindon city, Rajasthan, India. Hindon city is a very small town nearby Jaipur. It's around 160 km from Jaipur. And currently I am studying at Technische Hochschule Deggendorf, also known as TS Deggendorf, TSD. So I am studying here Master in Engineering in Mechatronics and Cyber Physical System at Campus CAM, and it's an English taught course. So this is my contact info. If you have any queries and want to ask any question, you can contact me via mail or via my Instagram ID. I will be thankful to you if you guys like to follow me on Instagram. So basically, I guess you all have a question that what is my profile and what all admits I have. So here I have mentioned my the profile. In 10th, I have done my 10th from the Rajasthan board and scored 83%. And in 12th, I also completed my 12th from Rajasthan board and it's with 85.40%, and I completed my bachelor in engineering in mechanical with 7.48 CGPA from Punjab University. On the German scale, my GPA is 2.2. Yeah, I know I am an average student, and I have scored my IELTS overall 6.0 in reading, 7.0 in listening, 5.5 in writing, and 6.5 in speaking. At the time of application, my German level was A1. Internship, I have two offline internships, one at a hydropower plant and another one at an Indian Railway workshop situated at Patiala. And my third one is the online internship, which I done during the Corona period in May 2020. I also have an experience of entrepreneurship, which I did in my 8th semester and 6 months after my degree completed. Extracurricular activities, I have PAHA, SUPRA, FE cycle, MEGA, ATV and other. Honestly, these are not going to be count during your admission. So I will suggest you, during your college time, if you want to do, then you can do 1 or 2 events at most. And focus on your research papers, which depend on your bachelor thesis or major project or minor project, and try to increase your score as much as you can. To get in a good university in a good course in English taught, you need 1.5 to 1.8, because day by day competition is going very high. So all the admission I achieved are Maschinenbau and TU Clausthal. This is German taught course. I received the conditional admit. Industrial Engineering in HS Nordhausen. Here also German taught and conditional admit. Mechanical Engineering in Duisburg. This is also German taught and conditional admit. Automotive Engineering and Management, University of Duisburg Essen. This is also German taught and conditional admit. And at last, Mechatronics and Cyber Physical System. This is English taught, and it's unconditional admit. So if you guys have doubt in conditional and unconditional admits, then you can comment below. I will make a separate video on that. That what are these conditional and unconditional admits. So let's, I thought to share my story of my the journey from India to Germany, because I think that my story may motivate some of you. So that's why I want to share my story, because I also have quite some challenges which you guys may relate, or you guys may get motivated from it. So let's jump into it. So on 7th April 1998, I was born in Hindon City, and from 1998 to 2003, I grew up, and the normal challenges as everyone faced in his childhood. Similarly, in 2013, I passed my 10th with Rajasthan Board, and then I moved to the Kota. So I was there was no pressure on me to select the engineering role. I select engineering on my own interest. So in Kota, I spent 3 years. Yes, I spent 3 years. On my first attempt, I didn't clear the exam. I was just on the cutoff border. So you know, at my first attempt, my rank was around 1.5 lakhs, and in my second attempt, in 2016, my rank was around 56k. So in all time, the board plus JEE main marks both combined to define the rank. So as an average student in my repeat year, I got the 56k, and I got admitted into the Punjab University, Chandigarh. So I started my mechanical engineering there in 2016. So from 2016 I started, and from very initially, I was actually, from my childhood, I was very interested in the cars. I was very fascinated by the cars. So that's why, that is the main reason of my choosing mechanical engineering. Also, another reason was that physics always fascinates me. I love the physics than any other subject. So I started in 2016, and from second semester onwards, I started participating in the motorsport event. My first event was FE cycle. So I did my FE cycle in my first year, and then in my second year, I did bar and go-kart. As a go-kart was a great success for us. We finished the event with a top 10, and then I made a team for the Supra. Supra was the very first team of our college, which I started, and then we participated. And till 2019, these all things, I participated in Baja 2 times, go-kart 1 time, Supra 1 time, FE cycle 1 time. So these all I do for to gain my experience till my 7th semester. In 7th semester and 8th semester, I have a major and minor project which I did in additive manufacture. It was quite interesting, and I have completed it, and most probably till as per my professor or guide under which I did this additive manufacturing project, maybe my book get published on the basis of my report. But it is not yet confirmed, may or may not it. But it doesn't matter for my admission, as till the admission applications, it is not published. So this was up to 2019. From 2019 till April 2021. This was the very life-changing period, and so many ups and downs. I will like to describe them even briefly so that you may get motivated from this. That everyone have to face some ups and downs in the life. It's the phase of life. So from 2019 till now, let's start a little bit before then, 2009. So when I took admission in Punjab University, I was started thinking that the college is just an average college. So to do something big, I need to take a good degree from a reputable college or an international level college. So I decided to do master's after bachelor. As in 2016-17, as you all know, we are seeing the high, the increasing unemployment rate in India for the bachelors. Or the bachelor ones getting a very low package as compared to master. So I decided to do a master's from a reputed college or country to do my master's from abroad. So after completing the first semester, from second semester I started researching in the different countries, what are their processes, what are their some things like what they need to get admit, conditions of admit, what exams need to be clear, or after completing degree what are their criteria about the PR and jobs, job visa and all, because this is very necessary. After completing masters you need to take some year of experience, no? So these all are things I started searching and comparing the countries. I compare USA, Canada, Germany, UK and Australia. So these are some countries which I compared and start checking, because there are three main factors: their entry criteria, their tuition fee. This is the main one. We can afford or not. As in USA, tuition fee was very high, almost 40 to 50 lakh is only tuition fees. So if we compare Canada and Germany, then Germany is more cheaper than Canada, approx 5 to 7 lakh difference is here. But for studying mechanical engineering, you all know Germany is well known. Also for CSE electrical, it's also very nice idea to study here than other countries. As per my comparison, it is economical and quality of education is also best. German universities are world best universities. So if language is not problem for you, then you can surely go for the Germany. Otherwise you can choose Canada or USA. USA if you don't have any financial problem. Otherwise you can go Canada, UK, Australia, as per your convenience. As per my convenience, I shortlisted the Germany. So after this, I planned for the Germany. I started collecting the information. Since 2018 onwards, I started collecting the information and sources. I started talking to the people who are there or not. Then I came across to the Bharat in Germany channel, YouTube channel. From there, I got a lot of knowledge. Then I also joined their FP community. I will share the link of these below. I know you all already know these today, but still I will share if anyone is new here. So after this all, after all this shortlisting, how I start actually? So let's break this period into three parts. The summer 2019, late 2019 to mid 2020 and 20 to 21 onwards. So at this time I was fully motivated and I was started learning for IELTS exam and for German. I cleared even in September. Give IELTS exam on 7th November. And yeah, cleared it on marginal at 6.5. It is with 91%. I started A2. And my A2 exam was also on 28th November. Till this time, I know that I have to prepare for the German till B2 C1 level because I need to give TAF. Because at 2.2, I know that I need to go in a German dot. Because I need to prepare for a German dot because the chances for getting English dot is very less in a public university, not in the private. Unfortunately, on 28th, I was unable to give the exam because a tragedy happened that in an accident, my mother got passed away on 12th November. So yes, this event was a little bit life-changing event. So let's start from the late 19 till mid 20. So at this period, from in the late November till December, I was at home for 3 to 4 weeks to support my family in this tough time. So after that, I am having the semester exam, my 7th sem exam of the university, which are going to start from 10th to 22 December. So first of all, I pay attention on this and clear it with a good pointer. Approx 7.4 or 7.5, I guess. I was unable to recall the pointer. So after giving the exam, I again came to him in my winter break, and here I started analyzing, decisioning, and like comparing a lot of things. Where are a lot of emotional changes, a lot of things in mind. So at the end, I came up with that I should postpone my plan to study abroad. So at the time, I dropped my plan and started focusing on my startup, my entrepreneurship. So I started converting that part-time business into the full-time business, and with my 8th sem, without wasting any time. So I have a small team. I have created a small team, a website, and all the stuff. And now started contacting teams and visiting events. But then again, in March 20, you all, the Corona came into the market. The deadly coronavirus. It again make my business idea fail. I know the market goes so down and all. So I can't afford the waste of the time. As per the situation, I see, I analyzed till the June and July. It was clear that for the next 2 years, market will not going to grow up, and it is not a good time to start a business. So I again replan and think, and then I came up with a decision that I should try once for a master's again. As I have my IELTS result, I have A1. So yes, I should apply once. So first of all, before applying, I joined the language panth in September 2020 for A2 B1. Yeah, because it was a long gap between the last October and the September 2020. So yes, I again join the A2 so that I can build my base strongly. So then now come to the part from September 20 till April 21. So at this time, I started learning language. My language course was A2 and B1, which was till December. And on January, I gave the exam and cleared the two modules of B1. I directly gave the B1 exam, so I cleared the two modules in January. That was the Huron and the Schreiben. अगेन आई बुक द एग्ज़ाम डेट फॉर द रेस्ट मॉड्यूल इन द विच इज इन द मार्च द लेसन एंड द एक्सप्रेशन. सो यस हियर आई कंप्लीटेड माई P1 एंड ऑन द साइड इन अक्टूबर आई इन अक्टूबर आई जॉइन द BIG अकेडमी. यस आई एम ए BIG स्टूडेंट एंड आई एम प्राउड टू बी ए स्टूडेंट ऑफ दिस अकेडमी. दिस अकेडमी हेल्प्स मी अलॉट इंक्रीज माई लैंग्वेज फ्रॉम 10% टू 80%. आई लर्न अ लॉट ऑफ बेसिक थिंग विच हेल्प मी टू गेट द मल्टीपल एडमिट्स. सो आई विल गिव अ सेपरेट वीडियो ऑन द फीडबैक अबाउट द BIG एंड बेनिफिट ऑफ इट्स जॉइन. या इफ एनी वन आस्क मी दैट दे शुड जॉइन और नॉट आई विल सजेस्ट दैट इट इज 100% वर्थ फॉर योर मनी. इफ़ यू डोंट नो एनी थिंग इफ यू आर एट जीरो देन इट विल बूस्ट योर नॉलेज टिल 80%. सो यू कैन गो फॉर इट. आई एम नॉट प्रमोटिंग जस्ट आई एम गिविंग माई फीडबैक माई एक्सपीरियंस. Then after that, after receiving the admit from the multiple university in German Torts, I research a lot. I will also going to make a separate video on how I shortlist the university, how I find that the university can give the admit in German Tort at A1 also, because I am having the only A1 certificate at the time of application for the SOSE 21. Because for SOSE 21, you need to apply in October. On November 2020. So yes, I applied at TDM. I will make a separate video on the process of admission and all. So in December, after 15 December, I was started getting the admits. On 2nd February, I received the admit from T.S. Tegendorf for this English taught course. So I decided to join this English taught course and will continue learning my language, because for the rest other course I need to clear the DAF or DSS, for which I need to learn till C1, but currently I am at the B1 level. So I decided not to waste time, just to start with T.S. Tegendorf, check my compatibility that I am comfortable with German or not. Because I can't waste the opportunity. So I accept the letter from the T.S. Tegendorf and complete the visa process and all. I took the appointment of the visa on 15th Feb and submitted my application at BFS New Delhi, and luckily I got my visa on 19th Feb. A visa approval mail on 19th Feb, and then I completed my stamping process in March, and on 9th April I landed in Germany. Currently I am at Calm, and yeah, it was a nice experience. And I will like to say to all of you that do not get demotivated with any of the downfall. Just grow up again and just try and try and try. I will suggest you to apply in as many universities as you can. I myself also applied in approx 18 to 20 universities, out of which I get 5 admits and 15 rejections. I know the pain of rejections, but you have to apply. If you are dedicated, if you want to be in Germany, the Germany is your last goal, then you have to do everything with planning, with proper planning, with proper direction, not in any direction, with proper direction, with proper documentation, because Germans are very strict in documentation. So I will suggest, do not get demotivated by the rejections. Rejections are normal. If you don't fall, then how will you grow? Have you seen a ball? It go down, bounce and every time it bounce higher. So the same you have to be. If you are falling, then found the reason of your fall and then work on it and just rebounds. And I know you all can do it. For any query, any problem, you can contact me via email, via my Instagram. I will be happy to help you guys in getting your dream true. And yes, if you like my video, if you want to more videos from me, and first of all and lastly, I would like to thank you all for watching. For my motivation, kindly please subscribe my channel. Thank you. See you in next video.